Hi, this is Thekla Petridou. Today it is Friday, the 30th of August 2019, and this is our weekly video in English. Today I'm not gonna read an email from a viewer, but I will try my best to answer a question from a viewer. Why does breakup of a romantic relationship hurt so much? Why do we hurt so much emotionally when we break up from a romantic relationship? This is a very valid question. And this is a question that I think has tormented every adult that I know of several times in their lives. Every time we break up from a romantic relationship, we have emotional difficulty in adapting to our life without the relationship, the romantic relationship. When we say romantic relationship, we refer to any relationship between any two humans that are at least infatuated with each other or in love with each other, and they are together and they are sharing romance and love together, romantic love, which of course it usually involves sexual intimacy as well. Why is it so difficult to accept the fact that we broke up? We broke up with our boyfriend, with our girlfriend. We separated from our wife or husband. Why is it so hurtful? Humans, we are social beings. This was first told, of what I know, from Aristotle, the ancient Greek philosopher. And you say also in English, no man is an island. Human relationships with other people are very important, very essential to our well-being as humans. We need relationships. We measure our happiness in relationships. You can go online and search for the results of the Boston Research. It's a longitudinal study which involved also Harvard University in Boston. And in this study, the psychologist who conducted it, there were many of them because it lasted, I think more than 50 years. They followed the lives of two groups of men, of young men at the time when they begin, and their families. The one group were from Boston University, students from Boston University, from Harvard University. The others were from a local a community college, I think. And they followed them, and they made, I think, annual reviews of their life. And they tried to measure several factors of human life and success. And when it came to happiness, they found that money, wealth, social status, success in the workplace were not as important as human loving relationships. We people are happy when we are connected with other people, but not with any other people, not with just anybody. You don't get happy when you go in a cinema, for example, to watch a movie and you sing amongst other people that you don't know and you don't have anything in common other than watching the same movie. We want special people in our lives. We need these special someones that are important to us. These special someones that come in our lives to fill the gap that the relationship with our parents or our caretakers has left because we grew up. Children are, in a platonic way, in love with their parents. I might sound Freudian, which I'm not, but I think that Sigmund Freud has said many truths. he was talking about the several stages of development and the importance of the relationship of the child with the mother. I'm gonna say with the father as well, or any other adult that is taking care of the infant and the child. Those prime relationships, those very first relationships in a human being's life are very important. And those are the relationships with the father, with the mother, with the caretaker, or the caretakers, are the relationships which give to the human infant, toddler, and child safety. Physical safety and emotional safety. But at some time we grow up. We become teenagers, then young adults, then middle-aged people like me, then we grow older and older and older. And at one point in our lives, usually after puberty, we stop having such a close and intimate emotionally connection with our parents, either because we grew up as normal people and we are not attached to our parents that much anymore, or because our parents are not in our lives, are not alive anymore. Okay, the normal thing is to stop being so much connected with your parent around the age that puberty finishes. And nowadays we know that the human brain develops and the prefrontal cortex develops until the age of 22 to 24 years old. So it would be safe to say that at least at the age of 24, we should stop being so much connected with our parents and be in being in a so tight relationship. But when you stop being in a relationship, a platonic relationship, with your parent, with your mother, with your father, or your grandfather, grandmother, or whoever brought you up, there is a void. That important other person is out of your life. You don't have somebody to rely on. You don't have somebody to keep you company. You don't have somebody to tell your problems. You don't have somebody to share your success, to share your happy moments. We need human connections, but true human connections, deep human connections, people who have empathy and they connect with us fully. They don't only make love to our bodies, but they make love to our brains as well, and they connect their hearts with ours. A romantic relationship is the purpose of a romantic relationship is to have all this, to give a person all this. Companionship, friendship, true friendship, love, sexual intimacy, care, and partnership in life. Romantic relationships are supposed to do that. Or we think of them that they are all of them able to come to that point. Not all romantic relationships fulfill our emotional needs and spiritual needs and physical needs. Not all of them. But any time we make a relationship, we still have maybe in the back of our minds, mostly people who feel more independent, we have this hope, this dream, that when I will fall in love and when I will be in a loving relationship, I will be happy. I will feel complete. I will feel safe, emotionally safe. I will be in a good place. I will be again in my mother's womb. I will be again in my mother's arms. I will be again in my father's arms. This is a thought or a dream that is subconscious. We do not realize that. You don't realize that. When you're going to flirt that girl on Instagram, on Facebook, or in a bar, or when you're going to flirt that boy anywhere, you don't say inside, oh, now I'm going to find somebody that I'm going to be so happy with as I was with my mom or with my dad when I was very young. You don't think like that. It's not normal to think like that. But subconsciously, in our subconscious mind, there are being these procedures. We have these expectations. We have this hope that love will heal everything, and especially romantic love. because there are people who have very good friends. They have nice communities that they live in. They have, yes, there are some such kind of people that they have a nice work environment, but they have friends or they have children, but they don't have a partner. And they feel that something is missing from their lives. Because all of us, more or less, we crave for that intimacy in all levels. And if we go to Plato's, the ancient Greek philosopher's philosophy, he talks about half oranges, that every one of us is a half orange, and we search for the other half to feel whole again. Me as a psychologist, I disagree with the idea, the hope, the dream that a love relationship will make us happy. I do not believe that. I believe that it's a fallacy. It's a dream, it's a hope that makes many people unhappy because they're not able to enjoy what they already have in life because they crave for romantic love, and they give romantic love so much power that they will make them happier, they will make them stronger, they will make them feel nice, happy, loved. No matter what, even if a love relationship is not fulfilling, when it's broken, when it stops, the dream is shattered. That's why breakups hurt so much. Breakups hurt so much because we invest too much on dreaming of being happy when we are in a relationship. And this is something that is not so good for our well-being. It's not so good for our mental and health status. Our mental health status. It's not so easy to find your soulmate if there is any. I do not believe that we are half oranges, that we need the other half. I just refer to the theory in order to emphasize on how so many people feel unhappy, they don't feel whole inside, they don't feel successful in their lives unless they have a romantic relationship. The truth is that most of the time, romantic relationships create many troubles in our lives. They give us anxiety. They give us many reasons to worry. Not all romantic relationships are matching. Not all the boyfriends or the girlfriends we have or we had are good for us, or the relationship with them is good for us. And by daydreaming and hoping that when I will be in love, I will be happy, this gives us sometimes a lot of discomfort instead of comfort. Lack of emotional safety instead of emotional safety itself. No matter what, though, even though most of us realize through our experiences, you don't need to be a psychologist like me. I am a psychologist and I've worked for 20 years with couples, in my private practice with couples, and single people, and people after breakups, and people that wanted to have relationships. And I know for sure, from my experience as a psychologist, that not all romantic relationships make you happy. Most of them make you unhappy. And most of them make you take a trip to the therapist. And most of them cost you money for psychotherapy. But even that, even though we have experienced this, we usually tend to hang on to the dream that when I find a man, when I find a woman, I will be happy. No, my friend, you can't be happy by having a man or having a woman. The only way to be happy, according to my opinion, of course, and according to my my life's experiences and to my theory that I have in life, and to what I believe on my belief system, you become happy when you manage to establish a good relationship with yourself. If you manage to be in a love relationship with yourself, in a healthy romantic relationship with yourself, not a narcissistic one, healthy romantic relationship, not to love your image as narcissists do, but to love your inner self. If you manage to forgive yourself for your mistakes, if you manage to realize your needs and desires and go for them, if you allow yourself to be human, if you allow yourself to be angry, if you allow yourself to be happy, if you allow yourself to be sad, if you allow yourself to be excited, if you allow yourself to experience all the human emotions that you have, and if you try to distinguish your emotions and understand from studying your emotions what's going on with your life and you have with yourself, and you have constructive discussions with yourself, and you try to make yourself better, and you invest in human relationships. Invest on human relationships that are less dangerous than love relationships. Invest on friendships. Invest on any kind of other partnerships. For example, get to know your neighbors. If they're good neighbors, make a friendship with them. Or try to reach with family members that you find that are matching with your personality, because not all family members can be a good match for us. If you invest on human relationships, and if you invest on cultivating yourself spiritually, then when you have a loving relationship, you won't be so dependent on your lover. And when you have a breakup, you will be sad, you will mourn the breakup, but you will not be in a mess. You will not think that your life has ended because a relationship has ended. So, I don't know if I have managed to answer the question. Why does it hurt so much when you have a breakup from a romantic relationship? The reason is because we invest so much on romantic relationships. We daydream a lot about love, and we put our hope to something that is not entirely up to us. Having a romantic relationship is not up to me, it's not up to you, it's up to two people. It takes two people, usually. It takes two people to tango. So if I expect to be happy only when I am in a love relationship, it means that I cannot control my happiness. But if I expect to be happy, if I try to be happy within my resources, I mean being happy by taking care of myself, being happy by educating myself, being happy by creating meaningful relationships with people in our lives that are not lovers, because lovers usually or most of the time tend to leave us or break up with us. There is this one relationship that might last many years. But isn't it that what happens in modern times? Most of the people, they have several relationships before they find somebody, or they are in an age-appropriate phase that they meet somebody that they have a good relationship with, and they stay in that good relationship, or a bad relationship that they stay with. No matter what, if we invest on ourselves, if we invest on cultivating spiritually ourselves, then we will be happier and without the relationship. I strongly advise you to read, if you haven't read, the book by Scott Peck, The Road Less Traveled. It's an old book, it's an all-time classic, which I think it gives you a good introduction to spirituality if you are interested in finding ways to be happy with yourself and with the relationship with yourself. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you liked it, you can press the like button, subscribe to my channel, press the bell so that you have notifications. Anyway, every Friday I release a video in English, which I post on my Facebook page with my name in English. Have a nice weekend. Bye.